Hello friends, welcome back. In today's video, we are going to see what is component hierarchy and container hierarchy in Java. So let's get started. Before starting this topic, if you have not installed Window Builder in the Eclipse, do install it. This tool will help you to design Swing application easily. If you don't know how to install it, the video link is provided in the description or you can see in the I button. Now let's begin with our today's topic. First we'll start with the component hierarchy. Now what is the basic requirement from a GUI to the user? The basic requirement from a GUI is to allow the user to interact with the system. In simpler words, the system should allow the user to provide data to the system and get output from the system. For doing this kind of unglamorous work, a set of simple display components are available. Each of these components is designed to perform simple tasks that are frequently required by the user. As you can see the component hierarchy image here, the component extends the object class and the container extends the component, and the JComponent class is the base class of all Swing components and which extends the container class. Now we will see some JComponents like JButton, JTextField, JComboBox, JList, JCheckbox, and there are many more components that we will see in the further videos. Now what is JButton? A button which is used to perform a click event is called a JButton. What is JTextField? In the JTextField, you will enter some text like short text. What is JComboBox? This creates a combo box with a specified item in its menu. JList, which creates a list with the initial list items specified. JCheckbox, which is used for picking options. Let's move to the container hierarchy. What is an AWT container? An AWT container object is a component that can contain other AWT components. Components added to a container are stacked in a list. If no index is specified when adding a component to a container, it will be added to the end of the list and hence the bottom of the stacking order. Container class cannot be initialized directly. To initialize it, its subclasses such as panel, frame, or dialog are used. Once a container is created, its layout manager can be set with setLayout method and components can be added to it with add method. And .getComponents returns an array of the components contained in a container. So that's it guys. Hope this video was helpful to you. Thank you.